Now let's move on to our second essential node, which is edit fields node or set node. What does this edit fields node or set node do? It helps you format, modify and clean data that is coming as an input into this node. It also helps you clean or remove any unwanted fields which are coming as an input data set, but you don't want them, so that you can keep your workflows efficient. The examples could be you want to remove unnecessary fields, such as you want to just keep the full name and you want to remove the last name. You want to just keep company name and email, and rest of the fields you just want removed from the entire data set that is coming as an input to this node, so that you can only process or work with these three fields later on in the business workflow. Second use case could be you need to format your data. For example, you might want to convert all your last name into the uppercase letters, so that you can achieve standardization in your data. Third thing you can achieve with this node is consistency. You want to ensure consistency. For example, there might be some data coming which may have null values, which may have n8n values, which is like not a number. You want to replace all that data with a fixed value. Maybe it's a blank, maybe it's a zero, maybe it's an empty string. This is the node that will help you in making your data consistent as well. So now let's get back to our workflow and see this set node or edit fields node in action. So I think I had already written some of the use cases that we would like to cover with this node. So if I zoom in a bit, what we want is tag orders based on urgency, and what if we want the full name instead of first name and last name. So let's just first do that, and then we'll start tagging orders based on the urgency. Now let's come back over here. Let me just look at what we had. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this plus node. Now we are going to go and search for edit fields. So you can see it is called edit fields or set node. You can search any of them and it will come. Modify, add and remove item fields. So as soon as I click on it, now the node configuration has been opened. So the first use case that we would like to implement is more simpler one. I'm going to use a full name in rest of our business workflow. Let's go ahead and do that. So first thing that we have to see over here is the mode. So you can see whether I want to work in manual mapping mode or whether I want to work in JSON mode. So if I have manual mapping mode, so this is where we can configure different fields, how they should look like as an output. Or I can also go in the JSON mode and start constructing my JSON that I would like to form from this input and produce as an output. So if I just test it out over here, let's see what happens. So because I tested out using JSON format, which is my underscore field underscore one equal to value and my underscore field underscore two equal to one, it has outputted this and it has excluded everything that was being input into it. So what it can do is it can even truncate what you are processing, and you can start afresh on the right hand side of your business workflow. However, we don't want to do this. So what I'll do is I'll go back to the manual mapping, and what we are going to do is I'm going to click on this add field, or we could have drag and dropped as well. I'll show you that in the next example. Over here, what we want is we want to basically have a full name. So I'm going to first name that. I'm going to follow the naming guidelines or naming convention that my data structure is following so far. It says like row underscore number and everything is like small cap, so I'm going to use full underscore name. Okay, so this is my key that I would like to use to have the full name populated into this column. So now I'll click on the value. So what value do I want? We can select the type as well over here. It's a string, it's a number, it's a boolean array or an object. However, because we are interested in full name, so this would be basically a string over here. So what could be a full name? So basically the full name can be formed using first name and last name, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this first name over here. So you can see first name has been dragged, and automatically the text box has been converted from fixed format to an expression format. And we have already seen in the last lesson that this $JSON, it provides you the access to the current item that is coming from the input. And you can see it says $input.item.json. It's a shorthand notation for that particular expression. So as soon as I have that, I can use the dot notation of JSON and access the property. So that's what we have done. And how the full name is formed? First name plus last name. So what we are going to do is we are also going to drag the last name over here. So right now both first name and last name does not have a space. So what I'll do is I'll just use a space in between these two. So now you can see the first name and last name is coming over here. So let's go to the next one, and you can see that for all these records, first name and last name have started to come. Now if I test step, what is going to happen is it is only going to return us full underscore name and leave out rest of the fields. We don't want that to happen. So what we want is we want other fields to be included. What we can do is we can click on this include other input fields so that all other input fields can be appended to the new field that we have created over it. So full underscore name will be there and rest of the fields will be appended to our each item. Now if we look at, there is another option that says whether I want to include all fields, whether I want to include selected, or we can also select fields that we want to exclude. So we'll come back to it later. Let's just first give it a run. So now you can see that we have a full name value as well over here and all other fields are included. However, this is still a little inefficient because we don't want first name and last name to come. So what we are going to do is we are going to use, instead of selected option, I have to select many of them. Let's try all except. So over here it says you can separate the two fields with comma. So I'm going to drag first name, fields to exclude, and then I'm going to drag the last name as well. So you can see that it has already created a comma separated list of our keys, first name underscore last name. These are the fields that would get excluded and rest of the data would get appended with our full name. So let's test it out. All right, so you can see that in the new record set, we have only full name over here and first name and last name has been removed. So you can see that that's how you can process or enrich your data or transform your data. Another example that I would like to show you is if I go back to my canvas. In the previous workflow, what we did was the operator wanted to send email in case there is pending orders. And in case of processing orders, we wanted to notify our operations team. However, we just looked at if the order was processing or not. So if I click on this, so what we did is like we looked at just the status called processing, but it does not feel like as soon as the order is in processing, why should an operation team get an alert? They might be working on it. That could be a legitimate lead time. So what we are going to do is we are going to enhance our workflow to enable some kind of a logic, like if the lead time has increased by 45 days, then only the operation team should be alerted because now the order is on priority because we have already breached our SLA of providing the order in less than like 60 days or 45 days. So whatever the use case is of that lead time, we can implement that using the set node. So let's go back and let's try to introduce something called order priority over here. So what we are going to do is we'll leave everything as is. We have the full name over here. We have removed first name, last name, and I'm going to click on this add field. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add over here. And based on this, we are going to check whether a Slack message to the operation team must be sent or not, instead of just looking at the processing order. So in this case, how do we set the order priority? Well, what we want to do is you can see that we already have something called order date. So over here, you can see there is order date and some of these orders are like from January. What we would like to see is that if my order date is beyond 45 days, then the order priority should be made as high priority. Otherwise, if the order date, the day the order was placed, is less than 45 days, that means I still have time to meet my SLA and I don't want the priority to bump up. I want the priority to only be standard. So that's what we are going to implement over here. And how we are going to implement over here, it's a string value that we have to put in. So how do we do that? That's where the expression editor will come into play. So I'll click on the expression editor and what I'm going to do is I'm going to like open up a pop-up so that we have more real estate and you can easily see what I'm trying to do over here. So in this case, we can write an expression and as you see, anything inside double curly braces, you can access the JavaScript. And what I'm going to do is because we have a string type of variable where we have to assign standard or high priority as the priority of our order, I'm going to use something called ternary operator. Ternary expression is nothing, but it's just like an if else block. So if the condition is met, you return one value, otherwise you return the other value. If I just write the ternary expression in plain simple English, so I'll just, you know, I have already written it, I'll just copy paste. So this is how a ternary expression looks like. You put the condition condition over here, and if the condition is true followed by question mark, so basically it is asking that if the condition is true, return this thing. If the condition is false, you put a colon and you return the false condition. So over here what we are going to do is I'm going to just write in true we want high, in false we want standard. So right now you can see that the result is always standard because condition is getting false, because right now it is not evaluating the condition. Now we'll write the condition. So how do we do that? I'll just write dollar sign, and you see I have some suggestions over there. If I write dollar JSON, that means I would have access to the current item. I don't want that. I'm interested in dollar now. So what I'm going to do is dollar now. Okay. So just enter. And then when I click on dot, it is going to provide me a list of methods that date is accessible to. So by writing dollar now, you have access to the current date, which is right now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this div2, okay? And div2 is the other date time. So basically we want to see what is the other date time. This is where we are going to put our order date. Let me just, you know, delete this and let me put this order date over here. Let me drag this. So it is $JSON.orderDate. So what this is doing is this is giving me a difference of today's date and the day on which the order was placed. And what we want to verify is that if the order was more than 45 days, then it should be high priority. Otherwise it would be standard priority. So what we will do is, because this particular expression returns the number of days that have been elapsed since the order was placed, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say if this is greater than 45, then it should return high, otherwise it should return standard. So now if we look at some of these orders, so if I like, you know, keep scrolling through the items, you would see that this particular item on item number 3 or position 3 has a standard priority, whereas the orders before it had high priority. So we have this working. I'll just close this, and we have another expression working. I'll click on the test tab. So now you can see that we have full name as well as order priority, and the order priority, we can see that some of the items have high, some of them have standard. So this one is standard, you can see, and it is placed in the March month. So that means the 45 day period has not been elapsed. So that means it is a standard priority order. So that's how you can use the edit fields node or set node to transform your data or clean your data, or you want data that you just need, or you want to leave behind all the fields that you do not require further in your workflow. You can do that using the edit fields or set node. I hope you are able to understand full functioning of this edit field set node, because this is very, very important node that you would continue to use in your complex workflows. Now, before moving to the next node, I'll just save this workflow so that we keep on building up on this workflow itself.